Alia, how are you?
Good.
Yeah.
Black Hollywood Live?
Yes. I'm not black. But
I know, I was like,
I'm actually.
You're represented, okay, as long as there's somebody here.
I'm actually Iraqi, like you.
No way.
You're the first, like, Iraqi American person I've ever.
Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Mina.
Mina. Keep Halik.
Oh, yeah, you learned Arabic recently.
Sure,
yeah.
Sure, sure.
Doing well. How was your trip to the Middle East?
It was great.
Yeah.
How do you know about that?
I looked it up online. It was like a recent trip. I thought
that's what
it was
happens.
Pretty cool.
Everyone knows about it. Yeah, it was great. I haven't been to Baghdad yet. One day. But yeah, I was in Palestine and it was beautiful.
Yeah,
I love that.
Yeah.
All right, so your character, you know, is struggling to kind of find herself, and it's interesting that, you know, there's this lady who disappeared and you were never really close to her. And it's kind of like this almost narcissistic friend group and personality, and she feels like some sort of connection or some sort of purpose in trying to find this person she never really knew.
Yeah.
Can you speak to that a little bit and what you think that character is trying to find?
I feel like you just said it. I don't think she knows what she's looking for, and that's part of why she kept stumbling further and further down the rabbit hole. It's kind of that desperation when you feel like if you don't find something, you just have nothing, and that's kind of the biggest fear, that there's nothing to discover about yourself or that we're not individual. And it does come from an egotistical place, even though Dory seems to be the more like likable, friendly one. She's actually, in the end of the season, ends up being the most like self-absorbed there is, because she becomes blind to reality.
Right.
Yeah, you know, it all comes down, people are scared of death, so they want a reason to be alive and feel like people remember them for something.
Do you feel like you finally found your purpose?
Me, Alia?
Yeah.
Sure. Every now and then it feels that way. Yeah, I love acting. I love working with the people I am working with. I'm still learning how to love properly, but I'm getting closer.
That's awesome. And yeah. What would your dream co-star be? If you could choose any A-list actor to work alongside, who
A-list.
Would it be?
Does that mean I'm like a D-list actor? Let's see. I think Oscar Isaac's pretty interesting.
Okay.
It would be interesting to play like siblings. There's a lot of great actors I've worked with, and so I'm never like, I gotta work with that person, but I'm trying to think. I really love that guy, Daniel Kaluuya from Get Out.
From Get Out, oh, okay.
He's amazing.
Great actor.
Anytime there's a script where there's like a love interest, I'm like, well, how about Daniel Kaluuya, if he's around? Yeah, so maybe those two.
And what advice would you have for people who have recently graduated college, are trying to find themselves, feel a little lost, feel purposeless? What advice do you have to them?
I say that that's part of it. If you don't have that, I think then you're more trouble than the other people. I started acting at a young age, so I kind of knew what I wanted younger, but I definitely at the same point, like 18 to 21, was like, what the hell am I doing with my life?
Mm-hmm.
Is this really what I'm going to commit to? Is this something that feels fulfilling enough? You know, there are big questions that everyone asks themselves. I say trust in being confused, and as long as you're open to opportunities and trying stuff, then you'll be able to know how to respond faster when it feels right.
Right. That's awesome advice.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Good luck to you.
Nice to meet you.